also recognize our visitors from the Kingdom of Lesotho, Major General Matobakele Matela, Deputy Chief of Defense Staff, Lesotho Defense Forces and Delegation. From South Africa, National Defense Forces, Lieutenant Colonel Njoko, Head of South African Engineers Corps in Zimbabwe. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Zimbabweans, comrades and friends, I am honored to join the nation today as we commemorate our National Heroes Day. This is indeed a solemn day when we remember and celebrate the illustrious sons and daughters of Zimbabwe who paid the supreme sacrifice for the liberation of our motherland. We salute, honor, and pay high tribute to them for their resolute defiance against colonial oppression, their bravery, courage and valor must serve as an inspiration and encouragement to us all as we journey towards a better and brighter Zimbabwe. Let us honor their sacred sacrifice and the rich heritage of gallantry they left for us by pledging to put our country first before self-interest or self-ambition. Let us vow to keep our land from foes, strengthened by the struggles and achievements of the past, conscious of what must be accomplished now and in the future. I urge us, therefore, wherever we may be, to build on this great legacy. Present and future generations must be brave and proud protectors of that heritage, lest we forget. We remember them individually and collectively for fighting gallantly. As we do so, we are aware that they received immense support from the international community for us to attain our independence. We honor their sacrifice and express our eternal gratitude. We also recognize and honor all those ordinary, everyday heroes and heroines, the villagers, men and women, boys and girls, who contributed in their own ways towards the liberation war effort. Ladies and gentlemen, comrades and friends, the experience of war makes people value peace all the more. As such, the defense of the peace and stability we enjoy today is paramount and must be undertaken with valor and vigilance. These heroes and heroines at this shrine and others at marked and unmarked graves both in Zimbabwe, Mozambique, Zambia, Botswana and Angola gave their lives to uphold this peace, this unity, freedom, justice and independence. Let us honor them by dedicating ourselves to peace. Violence, discord, disunity, hatred, divisions, discrimination, tribalism, regionalism, and corruption must be rejected as having no place in the new Zimbabwe. Mutual respect, love, equality, peace, commitment, loyalty, cooperation, and harmony must now be the order of the day. These values are engraved in our nationhood and indeed are an indispensable trait in our DNA. For this reason, violence must continue to be shunned and rejected. Indeed, dialogue and constructive engagement must be promoted as the centerpiece of national development. Under the Second Republic, let us all be determined to rekindle and permanently entrench that important national character and identity. The button is now with us. We must not be found wanting in the present battle for economic progress and prosperity. We must run the good race and fight the good fight. Long live our heroes and heroines, and long live our Zimbabwe. Comrades and friends, the national economic prosperity and progress we seek requires dedicated effort, hard work, and unflinching loyalty and patriotism, one generation after another. Allow me, on that note, to express my profound gratitude to all Zimbabweans for their patience and resilience, often against incredible odds during this period of reform processes. These economic reforms are necessary to right-size the economy and reset it for sustainable economic development for our motherland. Going forward, my government is now concentrating on increasing production efficiencies across all the sectors of the economy, starting with agriculture, which is the mainstay of our economy. This will be followed by the mining sector, which is the main foreign exchange earner for our country. It is against this background that, despite the natural calamities caused by the current drought, government has put in place sustainable measures to ensure a more reliable supply of electricity to support the requirements of our economy. As we commence the preparations for the forthcoming agriculture season, the uninterrupted availability of electricity should enable growers to increase their purchase of seeds to produce more tobacco for the next season.